January of 2016, the Bundy family led a 20-plus day standoff with the federal government that ended in the death of one of the occupiers and the imprisonment of the whole leadership.
This is one of the biggest provocations that we've seen recently. No BLM!
Our message was too important, and that's exactly why we had guns there.
We have a series of very intimate interviews with Ayman Bundy himself, who is in prison. And we also have great access on the other side of the story, which is what does it mean when local people take up arms and actually fight against the government.
One of the big fears is that, you know, those incidents were going to turn into another Waco or another Ruby Ridge, and they really wanted to avoid bloodshed.
We are at a dangerous time. If you understand history, how can you not think that there is going to be bloodshed or war or civil war?
As journalists, it's our job to go in to listen to what everybody has to say and really understand where everyone's coming from.
Really looking with care and depth and nuance at the contours of this new movement is an important thing for us in a country as divided as our country is now.